So you also have a filter output stream. As the name suggests, it is used for working on an output stream by manipulating the output data based on the certain filters. So we can filter based on particular conditions as defined by the user. So the filter output stream class also extends the output stream. The filtering conditions can be based on various conditions. So what conditions, such as writing only ASCII characters or writing the characters in the specific range in that of the stream. So next is our buffered output stream. So buffered output stream class enables output stream to buffer the data bytes that are written. So whenever I write the data bytes, so I can buffer it using my buffered output stream. So the data is written in the other streams are usually not buffered. Hence we have to access the disk for writing every byte of data. Buffered output stream is also a subclass of your filtered output stream. So buffered output stream maintains an internal buffer array wherein bytes are written from this stream. The data is collected in this buffer until it gets filled and returned to the output stream. So it means that the data is collected in the buffer till it gets filled, and then only it will be written into the output stream. So output may be anything. So we can write this into a file or we can write it to any device, whereas in the middle we have a process called buffering. So the data, each and every byte of data, will be passed on to the buffered output stream, and then that will be buffered entirely, and then it will be written on to the particular output which has been directed, which it has been directed. The data that is written onto the buffer is also written onto the output sink, where the buffer is flushed explicitly or the stream is closed. It means that, so the data is written to the buffer, it's also written to your output sink when the buffer is flushed explicitly or the stream is closed. So whenever I am trying to explicitly flush my buffer or I am trying to close the stream, the data gets entirely filled in the output sink. So next is about data output stream class. So data output stream class enables an application to write primitive data types in the machine independent manner. The data output stream class extends your filter output stream. The data written by this stream can be read into Java program by data input stream. So already we have seen that there are two types of data. One is primitive data, another one is non-primitive data. So primitive data is all basic data types like int, float, double that is available in your Java or any other programming language. Whereas non-primitive data types are like objects. So it means that I am trying to have an int as a form of an object called integer. So we have already seen in that in case of wrapper classes, I wrap the basic primitive data type and create a non-primitive data type, or else even other objects like employee, your salary class, your student class, all these classes are instantiated as objects. Okay, those comes under your non-primitive data type, whereas your data stream handles only primitive data types. So there will be methods corresponding to your integer, float, all primitive data types. So this stream helps you in writing your data, primitive data, into a particular device or to communication media or so. So we have a demo program here. You can see here, in the main method, I am trying to have set of arguments, two arguments. So now I am trying to have a buffer. So this buffer size, I am going to have or read it from integer. Integer is nothing but a wrapper class. ParseInt is nothing but a method which parses the argument 1, and then argument 1 value is being converted into. So it means that your first argument is your buffer size. So next I am trying to create a file output stream. So as already I told you, so here we have integer, a wrapper class, and then I have a parse int method which is going to pass the integer, that is my args of 1, and then it's going to state the buffer size. So now file output stream, and then this args of 0 is nothing but the file name. So now I have a buffered output stream BOS. So I'm creating this buffered output stream with a constructor in which I give the file output stream name and then my buffer size. So then I am going to have a data output stream. This data output stream is in turn this data output stream in turn takes buffered output stream as the parameter. So now whatever the contents I write into my data output stream will be written into buffered output stream and then into the file output stream. So now you can see that I am trying to write integer I, some I value. So here it's from 65 to 91. I am trying to write this value. So then I am trying to print that. So here this is ASCII value of your characters. So this will be converted or typecasted into character and will be printed. Whereas while I write that into my data output stream, it will be written in form of integer. So after writing all these characters, just I am closing my data output stream. And then here we have file not found exception. So in case if the args of 0 file is not available, just it will print that the file is not found. And then whenever I try to access the arguments, and whenever I try to access args of 0 or args of 1, if any of these arguments are not available, so that may raise an illegal argument exception. So and then in case of my buffer size also I raise an exception. So here you can see that illegal argument exception means that my argument is not properly given. So it means that my buffer size, whatever I enter, cannot be 0 or negative. So next we are going to see about PrintStream class. So the platform's default character encoding is used to convert characters written using PrintStream to bytes. So it's more useful when characters rather than bytes are to be written. So here this print stream could be used when characters has to be written. So here the platform's default character encoding is used to convert your characters written into bytes. So we know that stream itself means that it's in form of bytes. So print stream class extends the filter output stream class. So next is our piped output stream. So piped output stream class is a subclass of our output stream class again. Usually it works in combination with piped input stream for a communication pipe to be created. Declaration of this class is as follows. So public class your piped output stream extends your output stream. So here as told here, piped input stream will be communicating with the piped output stream. So it means that I am trying to create a communication pipe through which your data from your piped input stream could be read and the data inside your piped output stream could be written into. So there will be a communication between these two types of streams. So next we are moving into reader classes. So as already I told you that there are two types of streams. One is your character stream, another one is your byte stream. So far we have discussed about the byte streams. So now we are entering into discussion on our character streams. So as character streams, the class names will be represented using reader and writer. So whenever I say about the reader, so the reader means that it is of type character. So the data that will be written, it will be, if at all it is a writer, the return data will be in form of characters. If at all it's a reader, the data that we read will be in form of characters. So the objects, even if it has been connected with reader, so then automatically that will be converted into characters.